Hello and welcome to this Necron Dynasty Battle Ready painting video. In this video, we're going to be taking you through the key details of the various Necron dynasties. Now, I'm going to be focusing on a Necron warrior. However, the colour schemes will easily translate to any other model in your collection. Now, the first colour scheme we're going to concentrate on is the Sautek dynasty. So when you're ready, grab those brushes, shake those paints, and let's get started. Before we begin painting, the first thing we need to do is undercoat the model. As you can see here, we've used lead belcher for our Sautek dynasty model. Now I'm going to start with base coats. So I'm going to be using Corvus Black for the black details, such as the gun casing. We'll then move on to Caliban Green for any cables, and then we'll finish off with Corax White for the glowy effect, which we'll add later on. However, I've got a pot of lead belcher at hand in case I make any mistakes, I can just tidy back up with that. So first of all, let's start with the Corvus Black. So I'm going to apply a little bit to the palette, add a little bit more than that. A little touch of water, not too much, you don't want it too thick and goopy. The key bit here is just to spin the brush until you get a nice pointy brush. That's always handy. So once we've done that, we're then ready to start painting the actual model itself. So like I say, we've got the gun casing to do. So if you're not sure which bits are black, just check the box art for details. With the Corvus Black now dry, we're going to move on to picking out the cables. So for this, we'll be using Caliban Green. So again, just a couple of coats of this. So you've got one cable just drooping down here. Now, sometimes varying on the models, they'll have a couple of cables just under the rib cage. So you'll need to pick those out. And of course, we need to pick out a little ankh design as well. So what we'll do here is we'll paint all of that with Caliban Green, and when it's dry, I'm just going to pick out that raised detail of the actual symbol back with lead belcher. Now that we've done the Caliban Green details, we're going to move on to Corax White. So we're going to be painting the little energy balls here. This is getting ready for all that cool energy glow we'll add later on. So what I'm going to do is start picking the balls out like so, and I'm going to start running it into the actual recesses as well, getting ready. And of course, don't forget to do his eyeballs as well. And there we are with the Corax White now dry. We're going to move on to our next step. So we'll be using a contrast paint here. This is going to be Basilicanum Great. I'm going to thin it down with a little bit of contrast medium. The areas we're going to cover is the silver. We're going to cover the green and the black details. Now I'm thinning it down just so the silver pops out a bit more. So what I'm going to do is apply the contrast medium first to the palette, because obviously I don't want to taint my pot. So I'll just do a couple of dollops of that. And then once I'm happy, I'm going to get a dollop of Basilicanum Grey. So that's probably three parts contrast medium to one part Basilicanum Grey. So I'm just going to mix that together like so. Load up my brush. As you can see here, I've got a medium shade brush. Once I'm happy, and then I'm going to start applying that all over the model. Now, if you can, try and avoid those white details you picked out. But if you do get it in there, don't worry. You can always tidy back up with some Corax White after. There we are with the Basilicanum Grey now dry and any Corax White details tidied back up again. We're going to move on to our final step, which is to add Tesseract Glow to the glowing energy area. So anywhere we've base coated with white, we're now going to put Tesseract Glow over. So I'm going to use a medium layer brush for this. I'm just going to apply a little bit to the palette. I'm using it technically straight from the pot. I'm just using the palette just so I get a nice point like so. So once I'm happy with that, we're then ready to start applying that to the energy areas. So what I'm going to do is just start with a gun and then start running that in like so. And again, if you do splodge and get some on the silver, just tidy back up with a little bit of silver. There we are with the Sautek dynasty now done. We're going to move on to our next colour scheme, which is the Nilak dynasty. Now, as you can see here, the model's already been pre-painted. That's using the entirety of the Sautek dynasty colour scheme. We're just going to be adding some extra colours, which is the turquoise of the armour and also the gold. So first of all, we're going to start Retributor armour for our gold details. And after that, we'll use Thousand Suns for any turquoise details. But first of all, let's get some of that gold on. So I'm just going to apply a little bit to the palette. Little touch of water. Again, key to make sure you get your brush to a nice point. And then we're ready to start base coating. So the areas I'm going to focus on here is going to be his face. So I'm going to be painting this all gold. And I'm going to do the little ankh design here. It can vary from squad to squad. You can do it turquoise, then pick out the symbol gold. For this one, I'm going to do the symbol gold and then pick out with turquoise after. Take your time. You might have to do a couple of coats. There we are, the gold now base coated. We're going to move on to the turquoise areas using Thousand Suns Blue. So you've got the shoulder pads to do, so all you need to do is just give them a nice base coat like so. And again, moving all the way around, all the way down to the bottom of the shoulder pad. Now be mindful, obviously, you might have some of the silver showing through, so probably doing a second coat would be great. So just take your time building that up. You've also got the symbol on the ankh to do, so you can just work that on. But one of the things we're going to show you now is to actually do the little stripes. So some of them will have stripes on the helmets. Now it's always best to do this during the base coat stage, because if you make any mistakes, you can easily tidy up. So I'm just using the nose there as a guide. I'm just going to do a thin line all the way up to the top. Try and do it as straight as you can, keeping your arms nice and steady. You can make it broad if you want to by moving slightly outwards either side. And again, if it is a bit wibbly wobbly, just use that Retributor armor to make it nice and straight again. There we are with the Thousand Suns blue now applied and the little stripe on his helmet tidied back up. We're going to move on to applying some shades and contrast. Now, first of all, we'll be using Agrax O shade on the gold. Then after that, we'll use Basilicane and Grey on the turquoise areas. But first of all, let's start with that Agrax O shade. So I'm just going to apply a little bit to the palette. This is mainly just so I can load my brush up and get it to a nice point, not really thinning it down. And then I'm ready to start applying that to the gold areas. So I'll obviously do the face first. I try and avoid the little glowy eye areas because obviously you've done all that hard work up to this point. So try and avoid those if you can. If you do make any mistakes, just tidy back up with Corax White and reapply your Tesseract Glow. And don't forget the ink under there as well. With the Agrax stage now done, we're going to move on to using Basilicane and Grey. Now, I've thinned this down one part of Basilicane and Grey to one part contrast medium. So I'm just going to run that all over the turquoise details like so. Again, if you really wanted to on some of the raised areas, you can always tidy back up so it gives it a bit of a highlight. You shouldn't really need to. So just apply that like so and give it time, probably about 30 minutes to dry. And also just around the ankh symbol, I know there's some Agrax surf shade in there, so just apply a little bit of Basilicane and Grey just to give it a little bit more depth as well. There we are, the contrast now dry, our Nylak Dynasty is completed. So what I'm going to do now is move on to the Novak Dynasty. Now again, we've got this up to a certain point by using the Sautek guide, as you can see here. So all we need to do now is add the red shoulder pads and any white details. Now for the red, we'll be using Mephiston Red. And for the white details, we'll use Corax White. But first of all, let's start with that Mephiston Red. So I'm just going to get a little bit onto my palette, like so, a little touch of water. Depending on the base paint, sometimes you might have to add a little bit more water. This one seems fine now. And the key thing here, as always, is get your brush to a nice point. So once I'm happy with that, I'm then ready to start painting it. So we've got his face to do, we've got his shoulder pads to do, and the little ankh to do as well. And again, because it's red and you're going over silver, you might have to just do a couple of thin coats. Take your time. And for this, I'm using a medium layer brush. There we are. Now that we've done the red, we're going to move on to the white details. And for this, we're using Corax White. On Necron Warriors, you're probably only going to be picking that little ankh symbol just here in white. But things like Necron Immortals and some of the other unit types, you can just do the little stripes on the helmet in that colour scheme as well. There we are with that ankh symbol now picked out. What we're going to do now is move on to applying a shade. Now for this, we'll be using Agrax Earth Shade. I'm going to coat this all over the red. And I'm also going to just apply a little bit to that symbol just to help add a bit of definition around the edges of it. So what I'm going to do is just use it straight from the pot. However, I'm going to apply it to the palette like so. This is mainly just so I can get a nice point to the brush. So what I'm going to do is just run that round and I don't overload it too much. And then we're then just going to start applying that to the face. Again, you've got obviously glowing details there. So obviously avoid getting in there. And if you do, use your brush to soak up any excess or just reapply white and then your Tesseract Glow after. There we are, with the shade now dry, the Novak Dynasty is done. So what I'm going to do now is I'm going to move on to the Mefrit Dynasty. Now, I painted the majority of this model using the Sautek guide, so all that's left to do is the armor panels and the glowy effects. So for the actual armor, we'll be using Deathwald Forest as a base coat. Then after that, for the glowy effects, because it's quite orange, we're going to start with Jacaro Orange. So first of all, let's start with that armor. So all I'm going to do is get a little bit applied to the palette, as always, a little touch of water, and again, key bit, getting your brush to a nice point, and then we're ready to start picking out the armor. So what I'm going to be doing here is just start on the shoulder pads as before. I've also got the face to do and his little ankh to do it as well. Take your time and you might need to do a second coat. There we are with the green armor panels picked out. We're now going to start painting the orange glow. So I'm going to be doing the cables, the energy in the gun and his glowing eyes as well. There we are with the orange energy now picked out. We're going to move on to applying some shades and some contrast. So first of all, we're going to use Coelia Green Shade for the green armor. We're just going to keep this into the recesses. Then after that, we use Blood Angels Red thinned down with contrast medium to go over the energy. But first of all, let's start with that Coelia Green Shade. So I'm just going to apply a little bit to the palette, like so, get a nice point to the brush. And I'm just going to start coating that as much as I can into the recesses. Obviously, you can do some on some of the raised areas and just highlight back after if you need to. To do something around that skull area, like the cranium, just around his mouth. Now I'm just going to run this over the top of that actual symbol. Obviously, once it's dry, I might just need to reapply some Jacaro Orange here and there, but that's fine. And just go around to the shoulder pads and just do the same thing. Once the Coelia Green shade's dry, we're now going to move on to applying Blood Angels Red. So I've thinned this down to one part Blood Angels Red and one part contrast medium. So that's 50-50. So I've just been using my paintbrush as a tool. So one paintbrush of each. And all you can see here, I'm just running that into the recesses. You can still see the orange just raised on the top. Gives it a nice glowy blend. There we are with the red energy now done. The Mefrit dynasty is completed. So what I'm going to do now is we're going to move on to painting the Thok dynasty. Now, first of all, we need to undercoat the model using Chaos Black, as you can see here, as the majority of the model is going to be black. Now, before we begin painting any of the other base coats, we're going to use Abaddon Black as a base coat all over it. That's because Abaddon Black and Chaos Black are ever so slightly different in tone. So if we do need to do any corrections, having that Abaddon Black ready is going to make it a lot easier. So first of all, we'll do that. And then after that, we'll pick out any ceramic details using Rakar Flesh. And then getting ready for the energy glows, we'll paint those details using Corax White. But first of all, let's do that Abaddon Black. So I'm going to use a large base brush here. Just apply a little bit on the palette like so, a bit more, a little bit of water. And once I'm happy and the brush is loaded up, then I'm going to start coating that all over the model. So what I'm going to do is just coat the entire thing using Abaddon Black. There we are with the Abaddon Black now dry. What we're going to do now is start picking out those ceramic details using Rakar Flesh. So you're going to be concentrating on the face, his ankh, and some details on the gun as well. You might want to do a couple of thin coats of this just to get some depth to that Rakar Flesh. There we are, with those ceramic details now picked out, we're going to move on to the energy glow. Now for this we'll be using Corax White. So that's things like the cables, you've got the little glowy orbs in here as well. Sometimes if you thin it down, it will run into those cracks nice and easily. And don't forget the eyes, and also the little symbol on his ankh as well. And again, if you splodge, like I'm just doing here on the actual gun, just tidy back up with Abaddon Black. There we are with the Corax White now picked out. We're ready to move on to the next step, which is to apply some shades and some contrast paint. So first of all, we're going to use a shade, and that's Agraxer shade. We're going to coat that over the ceramic panels. Then after that, we'll be using Ethematic Blue for the blue glowing energy. So first of all, let's start with our Agraxer shade. So I'm just going to apply a little bit to the palette. Slow my brush up again. You're kind of concentrating this into the recesses. So what I want to do is then start applying that just around his cranium and stuff. So like so, just add a bit of depth. His mouth. If you can avoid like the eyes, because obviously you want that nice glowy effect, then just build the colours up. Now that the Agraxer shade is dry, we're going to start using Ethematic Blue on those blue glowy details. Just going to apply a coat like so, just on here and on the tubes, and also those glowy bits around the eyes and the actual weapon as well. On the actual tube here, I might do a second coat, just add a bit of depth, so a bit more on here and a bit more on that side. Take your time. If you make any mistakes on the black, just tidy back up with Abaddon Black. And there we are with the Ethematic Blue now dry. The Thok dynasty is done. So what we're going to do now is move on to our final dynasty, which is the Ogdebek dynasty. So the first thing we need to do is undercoat the model, and as you can see here, I've used Runelord Brass, which is perfect. Now we're only going to concentrate on the armor of this model, so for all the other details, just check out the Sautek guide for that. So we're starting off by using Screaming Bell for the armor. That's the bright reddy kind of panels. Then after that, we'll be using Caliban Green for any dark green armor panels. And then for the silver joints and in between, like the panels and stuff, we'll be using Iron Hand Steel. But first of all, let's start off with Screaming Bell. So I'm just going to apply a little bit to my palette like so. Get a nice point to my brush. And then we're going to start picking out those armor panels. So what you're going to be looking at mainly is things like the arms, the wrists, the hands, also the thighs and calves. With the Screaming Bell now applied to most of those armor panels, we're going to move to Caliban Green for the shoulder pads. There we are, with the green shoulder pads now done, I've also picked out the ankh on his chest as well in green. So what I'm going to do now is move to Iron Hand Steel to pick out his face and also just some select bits on like the exoskeleton underneath the armor joints. Most of it, I'll probably keep Runelord Brass. And there we are with the silver of his face now done. I've also picked out the joints on his armor and also the symbol on his ankh as well. So what we're going to do now is apply a shade, and for this we'll be using Agraxer shade. I'm going to apply this over all the colors we've just done. For this I'll be using my medium layer brush. So what I'm going to do is just apply a little bit to the palette, get a nice point to my brush, and then we're ready to start applying it. Now I'm just using a medium layer brush as opposed to a shade brush, just because I've got, like say, more control. It's got a nice point and I don't have to like pull too much here and there. So I'm just going to start applying that over those colors. And just take your time. And when that's done, just leave it for around about 30 minutes to dry. And there we are with the Agraxer shade now dry. Our Ogdebek dynasty is done. You'll also notice I finished the gauze flare off, and that is following the Sautek guide. And with that, our Necron dynasty battle ready painting video is completed. Now remember, you can easily transfer these color schemes onto other models in your collection as well. Now, there's a couple of things to remember. First, when using base paints, try and be as neat as you can. Remember, the neater you are, the better the end result. When using shades and contrast as well, try not to overload your brush, as it can quickly run out of control. If you do find that happening, just use your brush to soak up any excess. Well, I hope you've enjoyed this video. Hope you enjoy painting your own Necron dynasties, and we'll see you again soon. Bye-bye.